For through the law I died to the law so that I might live for God. I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me.
Imagine a church, imagine leaders, imagine seminarians, ministers who are passionate really for Christ, not for anything else, that are really in love with Christ, will honor their relationship with Christ more above anything else.
I aspire each one of us that those diverse students in this institution will be transformed to the fullness and likeness of Christ.
It all started with a prayer. All of us, we are convinced that we will never do anything, we will never do any project in the SC unless we have it founded in prayers.
You are no longer under obligation to sin. We must stubbornly embrace this identity. Our community should be characterized by the holiness of God. Our community must be characterized by the grace of God. Our community should be characterized by the love of Christ.
When I heard about the Spiritual Emphasis Week this year, honestly, I did not have any expectation. I did not think about it that much, because I was so driven with my classes and assignments that I did not really thought about that.
For so many years, I was really wondering, why is it that I really could not give God a shot in my life? I'm doing His ministry, I'm doing evangelism, I'm handling the youth, I'm singing in the church, I'm preaching, but it seems like there's a halo in my heart.
You know, before this Spiritual Emphasis Week, honestly, I didn't have any expectations because I'm too focused in my study and, you know, focusing on my requirements. And I don't really give special attention to this Spiritual Emphasis Week.
A week before the SCW, I'm praying to God that God will really speak to me whatever ways, maybe in songs, maybe in the message, or maybe on the circumstances that will kind of happen on that week. And that SCW would not just be a showcase of talents.
My expectation in the Spiritual Emphasis Week is that I may know more about God, to go deeper in His love, that in this Spiritual Emphasis Week, that I may be more passionate about His Word, that while I am here in the seminary, I will be able to experience Him more, and that my heart will be truly tuned to Him, that in everything that I do, that I would be much more prepared in my studies, and that there would be a revived spirit in my life, that I may able to give God everything that I can give to Him.
The Spiritual Emphasis is very important for us because it's a time for us to pause and ponder about what God wants us to do, and what God, to listen to His small voice. And sometimes we become too busy that we forgot really about God. You know, we live in a world wherein violence is really creeping around us, and the logic of unforgiveness is flying. So I think it's very important that our team, community of grace, Christ lives in we, such a very important and timely for us as seminarians.
Being the leader of the Student Council of the PBTS, planning for the SEW is kind of challenging, but by the grace of God, we're able to do it. I am just so thankful to the Lord for giving me wonderful people in the SE the VPs are just so good, so responsible enough to do their duties, to perform their task. I could say that, yes, we did plan so many things for it. We had prepared different programs, priorities and everything, but we just would like to surrender. That's what we want to do. We laid our plans, but we have decided to just let the Lord work in and through those plans. If He wants to omit some or to cancel some, then He can do so. So that's how we do it here in SC.
In Mark 10:45, that the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give His life as a ransom for many. So, if the Christ who lives in me came to serve, then that means that I have been called to serve. Remember this, when God called us to serve, when God appointed you as His minister, He gave you a towel instead of a title.
That line really like stayed with me, in that the church should really be a community that serves people, a community that serves others, even outside our community, even outside our faith, even outside our Christian community. We must really be serving people. It also reminds us that we are not meant to be served just like our Master Jesus Christ, but we are called to serve others. We are not called to a title, to a position.
The community of Jesus is a loved community. Love is the distinguishing mark of any Christian community that lives out the truth of Galatians 2:20. Christ lives in me, and therefore His love lives in me as well. Therefore, we are able to share His love with others.
Every word that a speaker speaks to us, and it's like he is just speaking to me, and I am the only one sitting inside the chapel. And I can feel that it was just between him and me, that he was just speaking to me every day about dying in Christ, about suffering for Christ, and about selflessness. And especially tonight, when you talk about honoring someone.
Yes, there are many parts, but only one body. The eye can never say to the hand, "I don't need you." The head can't say to the feet, "I don't need you." In fact, some parts of the body that seem weakest and least important are actually the most necessary.
Showing love, sharing love with one another, to live in harmony, to live in unity, to live having one another, sharing what we have, so that we can really show to the world that we are a community of Christians.
I learned who I am in this community. And the second is, how should I live in this community of grace?
The things that I have learned is that to leave Christ in me and to die every day so that Christ may live in me.
I will let Him be the center and the king of my life. I will crucify my life, my desire, my personal plans, my very own agenda, and just allow God to work in me and through me.
Christians, we don't need to shout it out about our identity being a Christian, but we need to live and act it out.
Yeah, buddy.
Christians, go mad. Make a difference. Boom. Bless them.